If someone asks you, where do you live? You will say, I live in a house which is located at so and so address. So this is your house which is having some address like house number, street name, district pin code, etc. And you are inside this house. So the person is inside the house and the house has an address. Similarly, when a variable is created in C language, where is it located? Suppose I declared a variable I. Now, where is this I located? So I is located inside the memory of your computer. Okay. And where exactly in the memory it is located? So it has a particular address. This address is a number. Let's suppose it is 65312. And inside this address, I is residing. Suppose I'll give a value of 10 for I. Now inside this address, a value of 10 is present. So I is located in the memory at a particular address, and inside the address is the value 10. Okay. Just like how you are inside a house and the house has an address. Similarly, the value of I is inside the location, is inside the memory location. And the memory location has an address. Okay. If you want to see the address of the memory location, you just need to put a ampersand before the variable. Let us see the address of I. We'll use percentile u, that is unsigned integer, and then we'll print the address of I. Address is 6356732. And if you want to know the value of I, you can just use without any ampersand and you will get the value of I. The value of I is 10. Why I used percentile u, that is unsigned integer, is because address is normally not negative. It is always positive. That's why we used an unsigned integer. If you are not familiar with the different format specifiers in C language, I will upload a complete video on the different format specifiers in C language. So don't worry. As of now, just understand that since address is not negative, we used an unsigned integer. Also, if you noticed, whenever we used scanf, we were giving ampersand I. Okay. So basically, we are giving the address of I. So whenever the user gives a value, suppose say 20, the 20 is stored in this address. Okay. So in scanf, the address has to be mentioned, not the value. So we should not give I, but we should give ampersand I. Now let us see what is a pointer. A pointer is a variable which contains the address of another variable. Example, here I is a variable. The address of I is ampersand I. Now there is another variable which contains the address of I. Okay. Now this is I, its address is 65312, it contains a value 10. Now there is another variable j which contains the address of I. So j contains 65312. Since j is also variable, it will also have its own address. Let it be 70132. So this is a variable j, it has its address. And its value is the address of I, 65312. I is a variable. It has an address 65312. The value inside I is 10. Now let us see how do we declare a pointer. We have assigned the address of I to J, but we haven't declared J. So how do we declare J? We will write int star J. So what does this int mean? So j is pointing to an address which contains the integer value. Okay, j is pointing to an address which contains integer value. That's why we have given int. Now this star means value at the address. I'll give an example. Now I will print star of ampersand i. Ampersand i is address and star means value at the address. Suppose ampersand i will give 65312. The value inside this address will be printed. That is 10. 10 will be printed. So 10 is printed. Now while declaring, we give star j. That means the value at the address is integer. So j will contain some address. So the value at that address is integer. That's why we declared int star j. We'll write a small program to understand all these concepts. So let j equal to address of i. We'll print the following. First we'll print address of i. Then we'll print the value of j. Then we'll print the address of j. Then we'll print the value of i. We can also print star j. Okay. So let us run this program. Okay. These values are printed. Now let us understand what has happened. First we printed address of i. So address of i is 6356732. So this is i. 6356732 is its address. Next what we printed is j. So the value of j is 6356732. There is j. The value of j is 6356732. Okay. Next we printed address of j. Address of j is 6356728. 6356728. This address is different from this address. This is 32, this is 28. Next we printed the value of i. The value of i is 10 because we declared here I equal to 10. Next is the value at this address. That came as 10 because j contains the address of i. J contains the address of i. The value inside this address is 10. Okay. That's why star j is printed as 10. How to easily understand this concept is, there is a pointer j which contains the address of i. So the value of j will be the address of i, 65372. But star j will be the value inside the address which j is pointing to. That is, okay. So whenever only j is referenced, we'll get the address of i. Whenever we put star j, that means we'll get the value inside i. Okay. The star represents value, just j represents address. Now let us see the following scenario. There are three variables I, j and k. J is equal to ampersand i. Okay. So j will contain address of i. Okay. 6356732. Now k is equal to ampersand j. That means k is containing the address of j. So the address of j is 6356728. So k is containing the address of j. Okay, now let's see what does star k contain. Star k means the value inside the address which it is pointing to, that is this one 6356732. Okay, so this itself is the address. If I put another star in front of star k, what will happen? The value inside this address 6356732 will be printed. What is inside the address 6356732? 10 will be printed. So the double star k is 10. Okay, let us try to understand this program. So there is a pointer j which contains the address of I. Okay, now there is a variable k which contains the address of j. So this is a pointer to a pointer. Okay, that's why we put two stars. It is a pointer to a pointer. Okay, star k is an address, so the value inside that address is integer. Okay, now we'll print first the address of I and then j, the address of j, I, address of k, k and star k and double star k. Okay, so let's see address of I. So the address of I is 6356732. Okay, we have written 6356732 and the value inside I is 10. Okay, the fourth one is value of I, we printed that as 10. Fourth one is 10. Next, second one, we printed the value of j. J contains the address of I. So j contains the address of I, 6356732. So 6356732 is printed. Next, we printed address of j. Address of j is 6356728. So 6356728 is printed. Next, we printed the address of k. So address of k is 6356724. We have written down 6356724. Next, we saw the value of k. K contains the address of j, so it should contain the address of j, that is 6356728, and 6356728 is there inside 6356728. Next, we printed star k. Star k means k is pointing to this variable j, so the value inside j is 6356732. So it printed 6356732. Okay, now we printed star star k. Star star k means this is star k and we are putting star in front of it. Star in front of this means the value inside this address. The value inside this address 6356732 is 10. So 10 is printed. Okay, hope you all understood the concept now. Pointers is a very easy topic. There is no need to be afraid of this topic, and with enough practice you'll be able to master the concept of pointers. If you have any doubts, write it down in the comment section below. I will make a video on that. Thanks for watching the video. Please subscribe the channel.